Hello, good people. What's going on? Good afternoon from Dhaka, Bangladesh. It's 3:30 here right now, and very, very hot and sunny day. So I decided to do three reviews for you. One, two, three. Yeah, correct. Two are from Niche House. One is niche. One is sort of like niche and designer is somewhere in between. Other one's definitely a designer house, and it's all of their upper class collection. So I would like to start with Creed. Many of you are big fan of Creed. I also have been a fan of Creed fragrances. I haven't tried all of them, but I did try many of them. I did own some of them. So basically, Creed is a house. I feel it's a pretty posh house. More on most part, they make fresh fragrances. But my favorite fragrance remains Creed's Royal Oud. Okay, so that is my most favorite Creed of all time. So let's see today. I have another fragrance that I wanted to try for a very long time. And I think this is part of the upper class collection, like more expensive. These are like $500 plus. Okay, they come in like big bottles, and then the minimum you get is 30 ml. And I think then you get, I think, what the big flacons and all that. So today we'll be looking at, as you can see from title, Creed's Jardin d'Amalfi. I think I did a review on Mancera. I think that was a, they sort of like made an attempt to make a clone of this. I think that one is a Jardin. I think it was what? Jardin exclusive, yeah. So that fragrance and this, not really same. I can tell you that one's not a clone, just the name was different. So this fragrance I want to try. I did try Oud and Spice, or Spice or Oud. I forgot the name. This is the same line. So I have an official sample that I purchased from Fragrance BD, and this is how they look. I really like it, but I wish these samples, they came with a picture of the bottle. I really wanted to show you, but I'll put a picture in. Wallpaper. So let's try this fragrance. This is an absolutely amazing fragrance, and it reminds me of one of the Creed's that I owned before. It's on my hand, and let me spray this and talk about it. Okay, and I'm really excited to try this. I really love this perfume. Okay, let's just go a little bit on the arm here. Okay, and this is a this is such a beautiful fragrance. Okay, first of all, let me take out the longevity out of the way. The sad part of this fragrance is this, even that Spice and Oud, or Oud and Spice, I forgot the exact name, they seem to lack longevity and depth, because these are, I'll tell you the reason. Okay, I used to own Creed's Neroli Sauvage. I sold that bottle, beautiful yellow sticker in front. That is a Neroli heavy fragrance. That was my top favorite, alongside Neroli Canvas, as well as Neroli Portofino by Tom Ford. Ferrari Bright Neroli. This one is also a Neroli bomb. This is very much close to that. If you also like Nishane Colonies, I'm sorry about that. So Nishane Colonies, if you love those fragrances, it's gonna be easy love. Even Mugler Cologne, Creed's Original Vetiver, or you know, something along those lines. This is pretty much there. But now coming to the smell, the refinement. Okay, the refinement in this perfume, it's so good. I say this is better than Creed's Neroli Sauvage. Yes, it's more expensive, but it's not because of that. It's just that ingredients they used. If you smelled 4711 cologne, that has a very nice quality to it. The Neroli is beautiful, but does not last. Same case with this, but this is longer lasting than that 4711 cologne. It has to last some time. It's $500 plus, for God's sake. So the natural ingredients, perhaps it's a reason this is not as long lasting. Like if you want something similar to it, you definitely should try, say, I would say Colonies by Nishane, or Al Haramain's Neroli Canvas. Those two are on steroids. But after a while, you'll see the comparison-wise, that natural blend. Nishane actually has that natural blend. They have the beautiful oil, but this is the most refined I smell in a Neroli fragrance. So it's Neroli dominant, but there's a tangerine note and a little bit of a petit grain of something. There's a spicy kick, something that you get in Mugler Cologne, but much more refined, okay? It's so beautiful, guys. It's just, it's not like exact clone of any of those fragrances, but the Neroli just stands out. This is something you just wanna smell all day long. You just wanna keep respraying out of the shower. It's the most beautiful cologne style fragrance. It's like a unisex perfume. Anybody wears this, people are gonna definitely love the smell, but it does not really jump out of your skin. It does not really project or last that much. That is the downside. I hope if you are into this game for getting a banger or long lasting perfumes, this is not what you should get. But if you just like the refinement, Creed's this one, Jardin d'Amalfi. You can definitely say the Amalfi lemon. I don't think they mentioned the lemon, but there's a lemon note, and then I get that beautiful tangerine, something of a orange nature, and then that Neroli, you know, like especially that Neroli orange blossom, not the powdery kind. This is more the citrusy, sharp, what, not the bitter. It's not the bitter. Bitter neroli would be the neroli sauvage. This is more acidic, okay? So sour sort of a, not in a bad way though. So very beautiful fragrance. It's so posh, you know. It's like, I would imagine it comes in a splash bottle and you take out the splash and you put it here after shower and all that, rather than spraying. If this fragrance lasted like 3 to 4 hours, this would be unbeatable. But that one category, that smell is so beautiful, but the performance cannot even match it. Like, let's say the smell is 10, performance is like 2 or 3, okay? It's not that bad. It lasts about two hours and a half, around there on me. Perhaps if you have better skin, better conditions, it will last longer, like 4 hours, but does not push more than that for sure, okay? So overall, this perfume, for the smell, I'll give this a 10. But performance, everything, considering the price point, this will come down under, it will be below Neroli Sauvage. Neroli Sauvage is a better fragrance deal to get, because that one lasts a little bit longer than this. Price will be half, okay, so, or less. So Giardini Amalfi, beautiful smell. Just get a small sample, enjoy it. Do not invest in a full bottle if you are on a budget, all right? So beautiful fragrance. Overall, I'm giving this, for the value, I'll give this a 7 out of 10, because the price point and performance, smell, 10, okay? So I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Time to move on to the second review, then we'll do a third, and that's done for today. Take care. Bye-bye.